I'm going to talk to you about the projectile motion lab. We have some equipment. We have a spring cannon. And now the spring cannon is set up, and you can pull it down. There's a spring in there. There's a lock in place. And then I can be able to fire this steel projectile. We'll fire that in just a minute. We also have a black background. And if you notice, we have a white ball against a black background. That's a good contrast. You could also use a dark object against a light background. That also works. You just want to have a good contrast. Next, we also have a plumb bob. Now, the plumb bob is going to help us calibrate our image by knowing if our image, our picture that we're going to take, or our video is square, or is perpendicular to the ground. If it's even rotated just a little bit, which I'll show you in the later video, you'll come up with bad data. On the other side, there is a ruler. The ruler is also going to help us calibrate the image. So we have a known distance of 1 meter. We'll be able to use image J to calibrate our picture and convert our pixels into actual units of measurement. Finally, over there, we have a basket that we're going to just catch the ball in so it doesn't get lost. This experiment could also be done with a strobe light and just a long exposure on a camera, but instead of using a strobe light and a long exposure, we're just going to use a cell phone and take a short video, and I'll show you how you can process that in a minute. Okay, now we're ready to fire the cannon, and so what I have is I just have my cell phone, and I have an assistant, and I'm going to just try to square this cell phone up as best as I can to the wall. What that does is it helps avoid, a little distortion in the X direction, a little distortion in the Z direction, so I'm just going to square it up as best as I can. And now let's get ready to fire the projectile. And one of the things I didn't mention when the projectile fired was that the cannon was positioned so that the ball was as parallel as possible to the wall, so that there wasn't any movement in Y. There was a little bit of movement, but we tried to limit how much movement in Y there was. And now let's go on to process the data.